Okay, so this example is an interesting example. I wanted to do this in case someone ever runs into problems that are related to calculating averages in the healthcare field with respect to some flow rates. So most people know that when you're going in the hospital, you know, if you have maybe going into surgery, or you know, if you're not feeling well, you're going to be administered medication through an IV. Now, if you're going to be administered medication kind of multiple times, sometimes it's useful to know what the average flow rate would be. So this example actually tackles this. Okay, so it states the following. So it has, prior to surgery, a patient must be put on 2 dosages of medication. So we have 2 dosages of medication. Both medications are administered via an IV. Now it says at 7 a.m., the patient receives the first dosage for 150 minutes at a rate of 15 milliliters an hour. Okay, so let's just highlight that in for ourselves. So we have our first dosage right here, and it is 15 milliliters an hour. All right, so I'm gonna write this as my given. So here it is. So that is the first dosage, and that one is for 150 minutes, and it is at 15 milliliters per hour. Now, the second dosage that we have, it states is administered at 11 a.m. So that would be my second dosage right there. And that one is for 1.5 hours. So let's do that. And it is at, okay, notice the flow rate there is 0.15 milliliters per minute. So basically, this is just telling us how much this patient is receiving, okay, in the first dosage, 150 minutes. And they're receiving 15 milliliters every single hour. In the second dosage, they are receiving it for 1.5 hours, and that one is 0.15 milliliters per hour, per minute. So now you will notice that here, okay, so in this case, if you're starting this off, and it's saying, you know, what was the average flow rate of medication provided in milliliters an hour? So that's what we're supposed to be grabbing, milliliters an hour. That's what we want. And it says round to the one. Now, that milliliters per hour basically guides us what we have to do with all of these units that we have. So nothing really is consistent here. You will notice that the first one is minutes, and then it's milliliters an hour. And then the second one is hours and milliliters per minute. So nothing really is consistent here. And we're supposed to be changing things up. And they want the answer in milliliters an hour. So when you notice this in these types of questions, you should make things consistent. All right. Now, consistent means that if they want things in milliliters and they want things in hours, then change everything to that. So for instance, we cannot keep this thing in minutes because that would be inconsistent with what we need. So they want things in hours because the answer is supposed to be in milliliters an hour. All right, well, in order to do that, so we have, okay, so I'm going to rewrite this, okay, so right there. All right, let me kind of zoom this in here. Minutes, we know that there are 60 minutes in 1 hour. All right, so we know that. Okay, so if we know that there are 60 minutes in 1 hour, so notice this is 150 minutes. And so for this, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Let me fix that one on top there. So we have, this is for every hour. So that's what we're gonna do. We're going to basically be dividing the 150 minutes by 60 minutes because that's gonna give us the hours. So that's the first thing that we will do. And that will make that first reading all consistent with what they want, which is milliliters and hours. Notice the 15 milliliters an hour is fine. It's already consistent. Okay, so let me rewrite this again. So the first, and now 150, let me clear that, 150 divided by 60. So that's 2.5 hours. So this will be 2.5 hours at 15 milliliters per hour. So now it's all nicely consistent with what they want here. The second reading, okay, so the timeline is fine because it's 1.5 hours. So that's consistent with the hours. But the 0.15 milliliters per minute is not consistent. Again, so that's a problem. And again, so just the same thing. So those minutes that you see there at the bottom, we cannot have minutes there. We want to have hours there. And the same thing, everyone should know that 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Okay, so in this case, since those minutes are in the denominator, so let me switch this here. Okay, so I'm going to multiply this by 60 minutes because that's for each 1 hour. So notice those minutes that you see there, right there. Okay, so those ones are going to be canceling out because you have 60 minutes in 1 hour. And so now what this is saying is we have to multiply 0.15 multiplied by 60 to actually get, okay, our reading. So 0.15 multiplied by 60. So that would be 9. So my answer to this one is 9 milliliters now per hour. That's how much it would be. And that should make sense to you because if you're doing 0.15 milliliters every minute, you have to multiply that by 60 to get 60 minutes, which basically means how many milliliters in 1 hour. And now everything is consistent. So this is the trick with this type of question. You gotta make sure that things are consistent on what they need, which is milliliters an hour. If they asked you for milliliters per minute, then you would have to change all the hours to minute. That's what you would have to do. So now, if I'm gonna start this, let me kind of define. I like to always define. So this is the flow rate. So I'm gonna just say let R, okay? So it's a rate. So let R be the flow rate. And they do want this thing in milliliters per hour, okay? So let's not forget that. Okay, so that's my rate. And now in terms of setting it up, okay, so let me write this out. So R equals. So now what is the average flow rate, right? What is an average? Well, the average in terms of these medications, you're going to have to see first, okay? What is the total medication that they received? So they're receiving it in milliliters. So that is volume. So what is the total volume medication? I'm gonna write meds. So you need to know the total, and then you're going to need to divide it because it's an average. Now, what should we divide it by? By the total time. So this will be divided by the total time. So again, total volume divided by the total time. That's what we need to do in this question. So let's set that up. So R equals, now what is the total volume? Well, that is how much they receive, right, each hour, and how many hours they received it for. So from the first one, so from this one right here, I have the following. So I am receiving it for 2.5 hours. And that's what I have there. And I am multiplying it by 15 milliliters for every hour. So if I multiply the two, then I know the total from the first dosage. Plus, I will now do the second dosage. So that's 1.5 hours multiplied by 9 milliliters per hour. So that is my second dosage. If there was a third dosage, you would have to add that in and so on. So that is the total volume that this will give. And notice here, I want to just point out, your hours will cancel, right? Because you have an hour on top and an hour at the bottom. So that just cancels each other off. And then you're left with milliliters, which is your volume. And now we're going to divide this and we have to find, okay, what was the total time given? Well, that's not very hard because they tell us that it's 2.5 hours for the first dosage and then 1.5 hours for the second dosage. So notice on top, your units are now milliliters. And at the bottom, notice it's all nicely consistent. Okay, you're adding just hours, so hours. And that's exactly what we wanted, right? We wanted milliliters. So right here, that's what they wanted. They wanted this thing in milliliters per hour. And that's what we have. So let's compute it. So let's see what we get. So on top, we have 2.5 times 15 plus the 1.5 times 9 equals, so that's 51. So R equals, so that's 51. I'll keep the units just so that you're aware of them, milliliters. And then at the bottom, I have 2.5 plus 1.5, and that is just equal to 4 hours. All right. Now, computing this out, divided by 4, so I have 12.75 milliliters per hour. That would be your average flow rate. Let's check if they wanted us to round. Yeah, they did. So rounding to the one. So I have to round this to the one. Well, one is right here. So you have a 7 in the 10th position. So that means this will be 13 milliliters per hour. And that would be your final answer for the flow rate. So when you're setting these things up, always remember that averages, it's always some kind of a total on top divided by total at the bottom. And in this case, in terms of these medication flow rates, it's always the total volume, right, of medication divided by the total time. And the other one that can be given is total mass, right, because sometimes meds are given in mass. So you take the total mass divided by the total time. All right, so I hope you found this one useful. This was a great question. So hopefully if anybody has run into this at some point, they will find this useful in terms of a setup. So just don't forget 60 minutes equals to 1 hour so that you know that you have to convert for consistency if it's needed. All right, okay, cheers.